this world is actually something else. Like, who on earth would go to the hospital to actually steal somebody's body remains? Like, are you for real right now? Are we still on earth or we are in Jupiter? Because I feel like so many things are happening. It's like we are no more in this earth. This earth is really not our place. How can someone pass on? They go to keep his body at the hospital while waiting for the time when he be laid to rest. And then people actually arrange themselves to go to the hospital and steal it. Like, come again, are you for real? Welcome back to this channel, guys. Sup with you all. I hope you all are doing just alright. Please, please hit the subscribe button. You don't want to miss out on any latest gist we are going to be giving you guys. So guys, we actually woke up this morning just to see this particular news spreading all over social media, confirming the fact that our late Prophet TB Joshua's body remains are nowhere to be found. And they said two men actually went there and decided to take it, two unknown men, unidentified men, that he went away with his body remains. So guys, they're actually saying that that is the reason why TB Joshua was not actually laid to rest in this same June, on June 12th. Because trust me, at first, they made it known that they wanted him to be laid to rest on the day of his birthday. Many people were actually like, okay, we want to know how everything is going to go on over there. All of a sudden, there was actually a twist where they said, no, he will no more be laid to rest on the 12th of June. He will be laid to rest, like, in future, consecutive dates that will be communicated. Well, it might interest you all to know that he will be laid to rest from the 5th to the 9th of July. There will be a ceremony that will take place live on Emmanuel TV where they will be showing you everything going on with Prophet or late Prophet TB Joshua. From all those ceremonies, I'm sure he will actually be laid to rest from actually on the 5th, either on the 5th or on the 9th, because his wife actually said there will be 3 days of continuous ceremony that will take place via Emmanuel TV station. So you want to do well to tune on to Emmanuel TV from the 5th of July. So guys, people are now saying that that is the reason why they shifted it to the 5th of July, because they want to take enough time to look for where the body has gone to. I'm like, seriously, Nigerians. We Nigerians, we make a big deal out of every single thing. My problem now is, the person confirming the fact that the body is nowhere to be found is a person close to the family. Does the person know the family? Going to the extent of posting this kind of thing on Facebook is so uncalled for. Because I feel like so many people want to actually use them to trend. Because you won't give this particular information about a particular man of God if you aren't related or close to him. Does this source of information come from someone who is inside TB Joshua's family? Is it from a close relative or is it from a family friend? Trust me guys, right now I feel like social media is one of the biggest problems we are actually facing in Nigeria right now. Because on social media we get both lies, truth, we don't know what to believe anymore. Me as a blogger, trust me, I really don't know what to believe. I'm actually sharing it with you guys because that's the latest updates concerning Prophet TB Joshua right now. And that's what every single person out there is talking about. But if you ask me if I'm sure about this, trust me, I'm as you are. I'm confused as you are. I don't know if it's true. I don't know if it's not true. I'll still continue my investigations. And I'm going to keep you guys updated. So what do you think? Do you think it's true? Did you also wonder why they shifted the date from the 12th, which was originally supposed to be the day where he will be laid to rest on his birthday, just as he wanted it to be? Did you wonder why his family decided to shift it right in July? Do you think this particular person said the truth? Leave your thoughts in the comment section below. Please, please subscribe. Do you think the government had the right to ban Twitter? Because trust me, social media is one of the biggest problems we're facing right now in Nigeria. Leave your thoughts right down in the comment section below. All your views concerning this particular video, guys, is welcome down in the comment section below.
You cannot continue serving God with physical strength, eloquent speech, your eyes, your mouth. No. You must serve him with all your heart, first place we must grow or prosper is in our spiritual life. Let me share with you why it's so difficult for us. After you have made a lot of money, you are rich, fleet of car, companies, you have a lot. Yet, there's a burden. Why? Because it's like we are prosper in our financial life, material life, and everything. But in our spiritual life, zero. You have money, wealth, so much. You have people. Yet, there's so much burden. Hardly you'll be able to sleep, but you are not sick. You need help of drug tablet to sleep. You cannot sit down any longer alone for 3 to 4 hours. You need to be in the midst of people to be happy. Great joy, joy that created, not joy of the Lord. So people will make you happy. You need to go to party, you need to go to club house, you need to go to occasion, you need to go to medical checkup, you need to go for holiday every week just to be happy. You are looking for just joy. The one you have is not sustain you. Now, reverse is the case. Our spiritual life first. Because this spiritual life is the one that carry everything we have. It carry our money, it carry our property, your fame, it is the spiritual life that carry them. If something that carry you is very small, you know the weight will be too much for him. The life many of us live is like you as a person carry this. If you carry this, you'll soon get tired. Your spiritual life is like that. What carry you is your spiritual life.